cut out this bottom bearing, see what happens. Kind of awkward to get at. So, put you up here for now. Plenty of sparks flying, no doubt. Most of the way through. I'll have to use a little grinder to get in. I'll have to do a bit of repairing, of course, to get it all back, but that's not a problem. Ah.
few bits sticking out around it. I think it must be well loaded. Bars maybe. Encourage it down. Tidying up to do here, but that doesn't come off. Maybe the play in that. So what the plan is, like I said, I'm going to put it in the lathe, see if I can cut out all this welding, and see if I can get it out of there and re-weld it later. Might be worth welding new material on here and turning it so it's got a bigger bit to fit. I think there's been a bush bit in there already by the look of it. Not sure what's holding that. Put a bush in, but they haven't bored a hole for the grease to come through. The bush is into the bottom, I think. Probably get that heat and take that out as well. Okay, I'll get it set up in the lathe probably tomorrow and bring you back then. GoPro, stop recording.
I've been cleaning up the rams from the bottom that were in all the mud, and I've discovered a date on them. Well, I think it's a date there with that light band, is there's 383, so I'm assuming that's March 83. The thing I discovered is whoever put these new bushes in didn't bore a hole through for the grease to come through. I've done this top one and I'm away to do. I was saying just before the battery died in this GoPro, that's the grease nipple I was trying to pump grease into. Oh, there's a little hole in this one. This is going to make it bigger. The other one didn't hold. So, blow that out now.
for a tiny wee walk. This is the original grease nipple. I'm not sure what the thread is. They've welded everything to everything, basically. Now, to get this out, I ground it. Just a round file. And I find where I put it up, you've got a wee bit of a dibber. This noga thing I'll do. Anyway, we can sort that out later, it's not a big problem. So to get this off, I cut it in the end, and then I discovered that the bottom thing's actually a big nut, which I cut through, so I've got to repair it. And what I'm planning on doing is, these are worn, so the shaft, this is your main shaft, so that bearing sits on here. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to weld it up and then machine it back to fit that, which is bigger than this. And then the other bearing sits up here, it's the same. I'll weld it and re-machine it, and then I'll have to... I was trying to get this off and I was cutting in here, thinking it would fall off, but it didn't, so I'll just weld that back up again. But it's nice and clean and V'd, so I've got a really strong weld. I've got 3.2mm rods to do that with. But I did cut a bit out of there, out that thread. I had this name. I don't remember what size it is, I didn't measure it. M24 maybe. M32 maybe. M28 with there's an M27 which is a 3mm pitch. That's measuring 28.8. I think that'd be M30. 3.5 pitch. Tap and drill size 26.5. I've got this chart here, it's quite handy. I probably showed you before. I think that's M30. So I've got the original nut, but it needs to be welded back in. This is how I got it off, cut it in half. So there should be a gap there. What I'm planning to do is put it back on, a bit of jubilee clip around it or something, and get a spacer in, and then try and weld in there with the MIG. Might V it out a bit first. I've lost the threads, but there's enough thread there to hold it. This goes on the bottom to stop it going up the way.
and then the bearing sits in here. This bearing goes in there with two thrust washers, and this goes on the bottom to lock it, but there's a gap there, and there's a gap. Anyway, that's the grease nipple of work now. I'll just weld this back on as well. Mine's easy. I'm just away to weld this up and then turn it back down to fit the existing bush. I've turned it already down a bit just to get the welding. We'll make it bigger so it actually fits the bush, and the same at the bottom there. Plus I've to re-weld all this stuff I took out of here by mistake. You know, those silly things you do by mistake. So I'll maybe do a bit here and then go down there just so the heat doesn't get too much. I'll put you up here at the road. Yeah, we had no power yesterday. I think old Storm Malik came in with 80 mile an hour winds, and it caused a lot of problems again with trees down in the lake. So anyway, get this welded. I need to turn the welder up. Probably 110 and see how we go. I'm just going to go this way. Maybe a bit more. Right. Got it indicated on the lathe anyway, so let's see what happens, shall we? Even halfway yet. Yeah.
I'll have to go and get more rods for the house. Now we just got to get rid of all that metal now. I think we'll let it cool down a bit before we do that. I might get a little bit of that, it will be cooling down, I think. I know people comment on when you're welding on a lathe, but put my earth onto the material, not the lathe. And I've got this leather jacket here and heartburn to go with it. Now a little story. Ordered inserts, which are DCMT something something 204, so D's diamond. So this triangles up here, which are T, but the boy, whoever labelled them, had put the label number on for the other ones. But it turns out I've got a holder for them, so I'm going to give this a bash. Yeah, and I've ordered the other ones. So we'll cut it that way. See what happens. Although I do have this CG, no, CTMG is it? It's the most popular one and seems to be pretty indestructible. See, now it's got 8 sides as well. I maybe just start with this because it doesn't mind intermediate cuts. not intermediate cuts. Not going to run it too fast either. 172 should be good. It's the end off the insert as well. That's at 45.20. That's actually where we want it. There's a couple of wee dings. I think we'll be okay. I'll maybe just tidy it up here a bit. We'll try out that triangular cutter just for fun. See how we get on with it. Just tidy this bit up to about here somewhere. Leave that. Those grooves will be good for letting the grease run round.